Batteries don't last forever, whether they're in your phone, EV, or laptop. Extending battery life is a major engineering challenge. But what if there was a battery that could last over 100,000 cycles? A battery that could go an entire lifetime with little to no degradation? Imagine guaranteeing performance not just for years, but for decades. Well, a team in Germany might have just made that a reality, turning a notoriously short-lived battery into one of the longest-lasting ever. So how did scientists pull this off? And more importantly, when can we start seeing these batteries in our phones, EVs, and home storage? I'm Matt Ferrell. Welcome to Undecided. This video is brought to you by Surfshark. This isn't just a battery, it's a lifetime commitment, and one with an extraordinary secret. Developed by the Technical University of Munich, or TUM, it can last for over 100,000 cycles. That kind of durability could change everything. For example, Elon Musk has said that Tesla car batteries should last for 300,000 to 500,000 miles. That's roughly the distance that you'd cover if you drove to the moon and back three times. According to Tesla's 2021 impact report, their batteries are designed to last the lifetime of the vehicle, which they estimate at around 150,000 to 200,000 miles. Now, this figure is estimated from batteries only lasting a few thousand charge cycles. So imagine what a battery lasting 100,000 cycles could mean for EVs, phones, laptops, you name it. Your EV might last so long, it'll have vintage plates before you need a replacement. So how is this even possible? Well, it all starts here. You might be thinking, wait, does that stuff that protects me from the sun actually make good batteries? And you'd be right. Zinc does actually have potential. In fact, researchers once thought that zinc ion batteries, or ZIBs, could replace lithium ion batteries. But the problem? Well, zinc batteries tend to have poor lifespans due to a few big issues. And that's where TUM made a breakthrough. They used an organic polymer called, well, this. And don't worry, I'll explain what that is in a bit. But when they applied it to the anode of the zinc ion battery, the results were nothing short of shocking. But to understand how TUM achieved this, we need to take a closer look at the material that they're using, which is obviously we're talking about zinc. Now, zinc might not get as much attention as lithium, but it has several key advantages that are sparking interest for batteries. First, zinc is abundant and relatively cheap. It's the 23rd most abundant element in the Earth's crust, making it far easier and less expensive to source than lithium. By contrast, lithium mining is highly concentrated in a few regions, and the refining process is mostly concentrated in China, which houses 60% of the world's lithium refining facilities. Now, the growing demand for lithium is expected to see the global market balloon from $26.88 billion in 2024 to $134 billion by 2032. As the demand for lithium balloons, zinc offers a much-needed element of surprise. Now, it's not just about abundance, though. Zinc is also non-toxic, easy to recycle, and pairs well with water-based electrolytes, which are safer and less flammable than those organic solvents used in lithium-ion batteries. Now, this makes zinc batteries an appealing option for applications like grid-scale energy storage, where safety is critical and space isn't as much of a concern. The recyclability and friendlier electrolytic solutions also make it a greener option. If zinc has so much going for it, why hasn't it replaced lithium in more applications? Well, the answer lies in a set of stubborn challenges that have plagued zinc batteries for years. First, there's an issue of dendrites. These are tiny, spiky structures that form on an anode during charging and discharging. Now, zinc dendrites grow in layers, creating hexagonal platelets that stack into needle-like projections. And over time, these needles can grow large enough to puncture the battery separator, causing short circuits. And even worse, they can snap off during use, effectively removing zinc from the system and reducing the battery's capacity. Think of the arms of a snowflake or ice crystallizing on your windshield. These are examples of dendritic growth. You can see that it can happen quickly, and once these grow and contact other conductors, the battery is shorted. Then there's the problem of corrosion and the hydrogen evolution reaction, or HER. Now think of the battery's cathode as a fancy hotel designed to accommodate zinc ions as guests. Now, during intercalation, zinc ions move into the cathode's layers, checking into their rooms. The more ions the cathode can hold, the more energy the battery can store. Well, zinc ions have a complicated relationship with water-based electrolytes. Hydroxide ions from the water tend to react with zinc, creating zinc hydroxide, which is a compound that acts like a rowdy party crasher, filling up all the hotel rooms and leaving no space for zinc ions. This means fewer ions can check in, reducing the battery's charge capacity over time. And to make matters worse, HER generates hydrogen gas, which disrupts the ion flow and damages the structure of the hotel itself. It's like having a gas leak in the building, which is both bad for business and terrible for battery performance. Now these issues, dendrites, corrosion, and HER, are the main reasons why zinc ion batteries have traditionally had short lifespans, often limited to just a few thousand cycles. And solving these problems is no small task. That's exactly what TUM's breakthrough aims to do. Before getting into that though, I just got back from my CES trip to Las Vegas and got a lot of use out of today's sponsor, Surfshark. I use Surfshark to protect me while using free Wi-Fi, but I could have also made it look like I was back in my home state. I've been using Surfshark for what feels like forever now and get so much use out of it. Surfshark is a fast, easy to use VPN full of incredible features that you can install on an unlimited number of devices with one account. But that's not all. Even shopping services will sometimes gate prices based on your location, so you can change your location to make sure you're getting the best deal. They also have add-ons to their VPN service to unlock things like Surfshark Alert, which will let you know if your email or password details, like passwords, have been leaked in online data breaches. Right now, they're running a special deal. Go to surfshark.com/undecided to get up to 4 additional months for free. Surfshark offers a 30-day money-back guarantee, so there's no risk to try it out for yourself. I've been using Surfshark for years, and I love it. Don't miss out on this great deal. The link's in the description below, and thanks to Surfshark and to all of you for supporting the channel. So back to where TUM's innovation comes in. Well, the research team developed a 2D porous organic polymer, which is this again, to coat the zinc anode. Now, while coatings aren't new in battery research, this one stands out for its unique properties. The polymer forms a protective film over the anode, but it's not just a barrier. It has built-in nanochannels that allow zinc ions to pass through easily, ensuring the battery can charge and discharge efficiently. Its highly ordered crystalline structure acts like a superhighway, allowing ions to move quickly and reducing energy losses. And the polymer also helps zinc distribute evenly across the anode surface. It prevents clumping that leads to dendrite formation. It's both zincophilic and hydrophobic, meaning it attracts zinc while repelling water. Now, this dual property minimizes the Hur effect, reducing corrosion and improving the battery's overall stability. And with this innovation, TUM has tackled three of zinc's biggest challenges: dendrites, corrosion, and Hur, all at once. Now, exciting as TUM's breakthrough is, it doesn't solve all of zinc's challenges. Now, one of the biggest limitations, like I mentioned before, is its energy density. Zinc ion batteries are less energy dense than lithium ion batteries, meaning that they're bulkier and heavier for the same amount of stored energy. Now, this means you probably won't have a zinc ion powering your EV anytime soon, let alone a smartphone. A zinc-powered iPhone would probably need to come with its own iBackpack. However, zinc batteries are ideal for stationary applications where space and weight aren't as big of an issue. In fact, zinc batteries have already started making an impact in grid-scale energy storage. One of the most significant advantages of zinc batteries in stationary applications is their safety profile. Even though it's rare, lithium-ion batteries are susceptible to thermal runaway, which is a chain reaction that can cause fires or explosions under very certain conditions. Zinc batteries, especially those using aqueous electrolytes, eliminate that risk. This makes them an excellent choice for large installations in populated areas or fire-prone regions where safety concerns are paramount. And zinc batteries also address another growing concern: sustainability. Unlike lithium, which is extracted through environmentally damaging mining processes, although there are some processes to address that, which I've covered in previous videos, zinc is more abundant and easier to recycle. This makes it a more sustainable choice as demand for energy storage continues to grow. It also reduces the potential for bottlenecks in the supply chain, as much of the world's current supply of lithium is mined in only a handful of countries. An example of zinc's potential is Eos Energy Enterprises. And this company manufactures zinc halide batteries for large-scale energy storage, which highlights how zinc technology is already stepping up to the plate. Now, while Eos's batteries aren't the same as TUM's polymer-enhanced models, they're an excellent example of how zinc can shine in stationary applications. Eos's batteries are designed to be non-flammable, long-lasting, and eco-friendly. Eos has made significant strides in California, which is a state where wildfire risks make traditional lithium-ion batteries less appealing for large installations. The company has recently expanded its California facility from 35 megawatt hours to 60 megawatt hours, thanks to partnerships with the California Energy Commission. This facility plays a key role in meeting California's renewable energy goals, since it provides safe and reliable storage for excess power from solar and wind with a greatly reduced chance of fire. Springfield, Missouri also recognized the potential for zinc-based storage because in 2024, the city purchased 216 megawatt hours of energy storage from Eos, aiming to stabilize their local grid and store renewable energy for peak demand. This project highlights how zinc batteries are already contributing to more sustainable energy infrastructure. Of course, Eos is not without its own challenges. Like many innovators in the energy space, the company faces financial and legal hurdles. Recent shareholder lawsuits and a reliance on troubled projects like BridgeLink Energy, which faced foreclosure, have raised questions about Eos's ability to scale. Now, despite these issues, the company's work underscores how zinc-based batteries are carving out a niche in the real world and could see even greater adoption with advancements like TUM's polymer. So when can we expect to see TUMS polymer-enhanced zinc-ion batteries in action? Well, right now, the technology is sitting in the lab, sitting at a technology readiness level of about a 4. That means it's far from commercial development. But the results are promising enough to imagine real-world applications down the line. And one of the biggest hurdles for TUMS technology will be scaling up to production. Lab-based breakthroughs often face challenges when transitioning to mass production, especially when new materials or manufacturing processes are involved. However, if the polymer coating can be produced cost-effectively, it could unlock a new generation of batteries for diverse applications. Looking forward, zinc-ion technology seems perfectly positioned to take on larger roles in grid-scale energy storage. The intermittent nature of renewable energy sources like solar and wind makes efficient storage a must. Zinc batteries, with their safer durability and lower cost, are well suited for that role. By complementing lithium-ion batteries, they could help diversify the energy storage landscape and ensure more reliable grids worldwide. Now, what I find the most exciting is that TUMS polymer is not limited to zinc. According to the researchers, it could be applied to other metal anodes, including lithium, sodium, and aluminum. This opens up a wide range of possibilities for improving battery performance and durability across different technologies. The benefits aren't just technical either. A 100,000 cycle life battery isn't just about saving money. It's also about reducing waste and making the energy sector more sustainable. Longer lasting batteries means fewer replacements and lower overall environmental impacts, which aligns perfectly with the growing global emphasis on green energy. It's also about winning the battle of consumer confidence, as battery anxiety in all forms is still a limiting factor for electrification. As EOS has shown, zinc-based batteries are already proving their value in this niche. With innovation like TUMS polymer pushing the boundaries, we may see even longer-lasting, high-performance zinc batteries becoming a staple of the energy storage landscape. The advancements happening today aren't just about improving a single battery. They're about reshaping the future of energy storage entirely. Whether it's lithium, zinc, or something entirely new, we're one step closer to a world powered by cleaner, safer, and more efficient technologies. But what do you think? Do you think zinc batteries will charge ahead in popularity? Jump into the comments and let me know, and be sure to listen to my follow-up podcast, Still to Be Determined. We'll keep this conversation going. And thanks as always to my patrons for your continued support, and a big welcome to new Supporter Plus members, Catherine Jefferson and Abhinit Appal. Keep your mind open, stay curious, and I'll see you in the next one.